Hello my friends and welcome to the channel today, your channel for fun and adventure in the out of doors. What a great day it is today. Today being Thursday, August the 5th. We are going on an awesome dash today. I am just so stoked for it. We are heading off to Manitoba's very first public venue since C-19 shut down the world. And this can be nothing more but a glorious, glorious day. So, what is the dash today? We're heading off, we're gonna jump on the bus, we're gonna head downtown, and we're gonna jump on the bus out to the university, and we're heading out to Investors Group Field to see my Hamilton Tiger Cats take on the city that I live in, the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. It's the very first time that there's been a public venue where we can all gather together again. Awesome. So there's a few things. I have to wear my muzzle to jump on the city bus. My tickets are, you scan my tickets on my cell phone. I have both my, I'm double vaxxed. I'm vaxxed maxed, if you will. I have both my Moderna shots. I have that QR code on my phone as well. So that allows entry into the stadium and into seeing the game. And I'm so pumped because not only do I love my Hamilton Tiger Cats, and I especially love my Hamilton Tiger Cats when they visit the city that I live in and take on the team of the city that I live in, which is awesome. But it's the very first time, man, that it's like we're coming back. It's like life is coming back. And I mean, it's nothing but awesome, right? So stoked. We're just waiting for the bus to come. While we're waiting for the bus to come, let's roll a brand new intro for you, and then we'll jump off the bus at the field. Here we go. This is an adventure I'm never gonna forget, I tell you what. Oh, heartbroken. Man, what a cluster bunch of fudge was that. It's now 5 to 7. And I realize I didn't bring my wallet for my ID. Apparently I need my wallet for my ID. So I'll tell you what happened. I'm the caretaker in my building. And it being the 5th of August, there was a new tenant moving in today, and I had to hand off the keys. And of course, the new tenant didn't get there. By the time everything was done, I had missed the first bus that I wanted to take. But in the waiting, I got flustered, and I forgot to grab my wallet and my eyeglasses. Well, the eyeglasses is whatever. I'm not that blind. No. So anyways, I forgot my ID. And I don't know, the bus driver says that I should have just tried it. With the QR code for my tickets and my COVID shot. See, here's my bus stop, but I don't know what time this thing comes. So maybe I'll just keep walking. Got to put in the effort, I guess, right? So I was almost to the stadium and I realized, man, I didn't freaking bring my damn IDs. So I quick jumped off the bus and ran across the road. The bus that I took down there, oh, what bus is this? Shit, I think maybe this might be my bus. Right here coming. I don't know. It would be sweet if it was. I don't know why he's just stopped there. Oh, now I just ran back across. Chasing a bus is not freaking coming. Dang it, man. All right, let's do some more jaywalking. Life, eh? Just sometimes. Sometimes I just, oh, what a knothead I am. Throw the wallet in the bag, but I don't carry my wallet with me. You know, so I go home from work, I don't carry my wallet to work. I don't need to carry my wallet to work. Like, for what? I go to work to make money, not spend it. So I don't carry bank cards and stuff like that with me to work. I don't need my ID to go to work. Ah, frustrating, man. I just want to be at the game. The game kicks off in 34 minutes. So we're going to be late, but we're going to make it. Anyways, I'm going to bring it to you guys the way it happens. So that's just the way it is. But, all right. We'll catch up when we catch another bus, I guess. And there I go with that. Yeah, I'm going to try to get home as fast as I can. Grab that ID. Grab my eyeglasses while I'm there. I mean, they're sitting right beside my ID. And we'll jump another bus. Try to get back to the stadium as fast as possible. We're not going to see the opening kickoff. That's a bummer. But at least we're still going to get to the game. So all hope is not lost for a great evening. So, all right, guys, gals, my friends. Well, we're back to the spot where we caught the 47 that takes us out to the stadium again. So I grabbed the wallet. I grabbed the specs, as you can see. Kickoff is in 7 minutes. We're gonna miss it. But this bus usually runs, especially because it's a stadium bus. There should be every half hour, 20 minutes anyways. So we're hopeful we'll be there within minutes after the kickoff. So we'll have to see. But that's the update. I got off the bus. There was no bus here to get me to my house, so I ran 6 blocks. Got in my house, ran 6 blocks back, and now we're just waiting on this next bus. So, with any luck, it'll be here anytime soon, and we can get this show on the road. So, I'm just trying to remember, like, when's the last time? Like, this is the first CFL game since the 2019 Grey Cup. And that's been a long time, especially if you're a sports fan. That's a heck of a long time to go without the love of your sport, you know? So, but where's the bus? Where's the bus? Come on, where's the buses? I'm on a huge main drag here. Where's all the buses? It's always when you're in a hurry, you know? It's always when you're in a hurry. So, anyways, that's the update. We're waiting on the bus to get us to the stadium. So, hopefully that's all our blunders are done. I'm just going to chalk this up to, I just couldn't get there before this. I'm not going to beat myself up about making a simple little mistake. No sense in doing that in life. So anyways, we got a bus coming. We'll see what this one is. Catch up to you, either on the bus or getting off the bus.
University at 9:30.
Oh, that was painful. But now we're gonna shake it off because we're here. I think. I don't know where I'm going. But the roar of the crowd is getting me re-energized. And that's a great thing. So I stepped on the bus to get out here. Exactly kickoff at 7:30. It is now 8:02. So A little bit of punishment for my mistake, but that's all right. We're not gonna beat ourselves up over it. Oh, and my team's up 6-0 already. Find our seats. I gotta find out where I'm sitting. Guys, well, can't see the screen with my glasses on right now. Hamilton certainly played like a team that hadn't been playing for a couple years, that's for sure. But good thing is that Winnipeg, the city that I live in, they played really well. So that was pretty cool. That's always good for the city that I live in, for their teams to do well. Yeah, but the time is like 10:30. I gotta work tomorrow. I gotta get out of here. But it was really good to get out and be around people. No muzzles on. It's really awesome not to have a muzzle on today. And yeah, what else can I say? It was a little overbearing at halftime when I was trying to make my way out for a cigarette. Just the amount of people that were just pushing, shoving. There was fist fights going on. That was a little bit ridiculous. So hopefully people get their shit together when it comes to that kind of stuff. Yeah, it was just, like I said, it was just great to get out, great to get into society again, muzzles off, and just enjoy a good night out. Yeah, now I gotta truck it out here and try to find my bus somewhere. Here's some information for you. I took that bus ride back to get my frickin' IDs, which I didn't need at all. And even more surprisingly, nobody even checked to see if I had a ticket. They put this gold band on me, which proves that I'm COVID free, but not one person checked to see if I had a ticket. So I went all the way back home again for nothing, for no reason. And, something else just happened. Oh well. Yeah, so they didn't check for my tickets. They didn't check my IDs, so I didn't need them. So I wasted that time. Lessons learned. But whatever. I guess everybody's going through that growing pain of trying to figure out how things work again. So without further ado, I'm gonna get out of here because this place is gonna unload, and then I'm gonna be waiting for 3 hours for a bus. So we don't want that. Anyways, guys, we'll catch up maybe. Maybe in a bit. Or maybe I won't. I don't know. So. It's time to go. Everybody's making a run for it. Hey guys, well, we're back on the bus. We've got ride checks here leaving the stadium, which is a good thing because there are a lot of inebriated people there. Again, it was just a good night out. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to the channel today, and if you can find it, to give this video a like. The world is starting to open back up, and that's pretty awesome. So, yeah, it was a good night. The team didn't do so well, but the team that in the city that I live in, they did pretty good, so that's all right. Again, it wasn't really so much the game. It was more the just getting back out into life. So, yeah. Well, until the next one, guys, remember to get out and stay out.